Hey, good morning there. This is Joe Van Cleve, and welcome to another episode of the Typewriter video series. Today, I'm going to step back a little bit and kind of talk about, for myself, why typewriters. Stay tuned. Throughout the duration of this series, I've done a lot of discussion about different kinds of typewriters and how to use them and a lot of the general usage modes and culture around typewriters. But I've never really delved much into the why of typewriters, and especially these manual typewriters that I seem to be so fond of. And so I thought it would be a good opportunity today to kind of sit down and discuss a little bit about why the typewriter. Now, the reason why this subject comes up this week is because I've had an opportunity I'm having an opportunity this week to discuss my involvement with typewriters with an Associated Press reporter. And the interview has not happened yet, so it might be a little bit premature for me to be talking about this, but we'll just leave it at that. I'll give you more information later. But in the process of kind of preparing my thoughts for this upcoming interview, I've had to sit down and kind of put my thoughts together about what is it about typewriters that I enjoy? How do I use them? What do they mean to me? What is their significance? And so I'd kind of like to touch on a few of these issues today. First of all, a brief point about my history of typewriter usage. And I've delved in this in the past. I'm not going to go too much into detail, but just suffice to say that back in the late 70s and early 1980s, I was using electric typewriters, and I really appreciated them for the really precise quality of their print with the carbon film ribbons. And at the time, I did have a chance to use a manual typewriter. I think it was a Royal, and I didn't really appreciate at the time the mechanicalness of the typewriter, of the manual typewriter. What I really didn't like was the quality or lack thereof of the cloth ribbon imprint as compared to a carbon film ribbon. And so that was kind of where I left typewriters back in the 1980s, manual typewriters. But I had a colleague at work who used small portable typewriters, manual typewriters, and I was always intrigued by his enthusiasm for them and how he wrote stories with them, and even made one-off typewritten books. And that kind of stuck with me over the years. And so then in the mid-aughts, the mid-2000s, I finally got bitten by the manual typewriter bug. So why typewriters for me? Well, first of all, the first thing that a lot of people ask about typewriters is, why would you use a typewriter instead of a computer? And for me, the answer is, that's not true at all. I don't use typewriters in place of a computer. That is not how typewriters are used in my life. To me, typewriters are another technology that runs parallel to the computer. It is a tool I use as part of a larger workflow of creating written work. Typewriters are different from computers. I really believe that typewriters, manual typewriters especially, I think they use a different part of the brain than computer keyboarding. In thinking about manual typewriters and what I like about them so much, one of the ideas that I've developed is this word cybernetic. Now, I'm not talking about L. Ron Hubbard when I say cybernetic, okay? What I'm referring to is this idea that manual typewriters are this intimate connection between the biological and the mechanical. When you're using your fingers on the keys of the typewriter, your ligaments and nerves and muscles and tendons of your hands and fingers are directly linked to the mechanical linkage of the typewriter itself. It's a continuation of a linkage system that starts out biological, ends up mechanical. And there's continuous feedback throughout this typing cycle. You can feel the force or the resistance of the typing linkage on your fingers. You can tell, even typing with your eyes closed, whether or not you've adequately struck a key hard enough and fast enough. You don't even have to look at the imprint to know that, oh, I think I didn't hit that hard enough, or I mishit that, because there's this continuous sense of feedback. So typewriters, manual typewriters, you have this direct physical connection. It's cybernetic. It melds the biological with the mechanical. And because of that, there is very little of what I call mediation, which is a term referring to some kind of a system that intervenes between your direct biomechanics and what you're trying to do on paper. There's very little of this intermediary mediation going on with typewriters, compared to, for instance, a word processor that is being hosted on a computer platform. You have the operating system, the mouse, the shortcut keyboard commands, thoughts about where am I going to save this file to? What kind of file name am I going to save it to? Do I need to put it in a different folder with the other parts of this work? Am I going to be saving this to the cloud in some format? All these thoughts are running through your head when you're using a word processor, and the other parts of the software are kind of mediating your experience. It's trying to make it look like a typewritten page if you're using the print preview view, but it's not. It tries to do autocorrect, auto-formatting of the lines. It suggests grammar correction, for instance, in many cases. So there's a lot about the word processing experience that is mediated. But mechanical typewriters are very unmediated. It is just a direct physical linkage between your fingers and a printed character on paper. The surprising thing that I have personally discovered about manual typewriters is that they are a surprisingly effective tool for creation. And I'm referring to the early first draft stages of writing. I find manual typewriters are, because they're direct, cybernetic, and they're very unmediated as an experience, I believe they become really a transparent tool. And I find sitting down at a typewriter, I'm much more able to open my mind and pour out words onto paper that I normally wouldn't even write in a computer or even other electronic kinds of platforms like Alpha Smart Neos or whatever. Even handwritten to a journal, I don't get the same sense of freedom as I do with a typewriter. And I'm not really sure why. I haven't really worked it out in my mind as to what all is going on there. But I do know that there is this kind of stream of consciousness writing experience, the very early parts of creativity, that the typewriter seems especially adept at. Contrasting this to the word processor computer platform, which, if you want to think of it as a continuous writing process, the manual typewriter up front in the early stages of creativity, whereas on the back end of the process, the word processor computer platform becomes more of a utilitarian wordsmithing tool, crafting the final product, polishing sentence structure, moving things around, getting them in a finished form, and then finally creating a document format that is socially acceptable by the rest of society, which is some kind of a word processing document. So that's kind of the writing workflow that I see typewriters fit into. It's not a question of typewriters or computers, in my mind. It's a question of they can both coexist alongside each other. They both have individual unique strengths and weaknesses. And unlike the way typewriters were once used in the office environment in the pre-computer era, today they don't serve that same function. They've been supplanted by computers. But they do serve, I believe, this creativity role because of their lack of mediation and their direct physical connection, the cybernetic connection. I believe they really do function as a highly effective creative tool. Now, when it comes to the type of typewriters that I really like, you guys know that I really kind of prefer portables or ultra portables, not because of necessarily their feel or the typing action, because oftentimes ultra portables have a compromise in the way they feel the touch of the typewriter simply because of the compromises of the design. But one of the things I really appreciate about ultra portables is that it unchains the typewriter from the traditional location of on the desk in the office. Ultra portables enable you to do this direct unmediated writing experience out and about in different locations that might be much more amenitive to opening up your creative potential. Because of the setting, the inspiration of the setting, whether it's on a park bench or in your backyard under a tree or in your favorite comfortable chair or in your den, wherever that might be, they do seem to facilitate this creative outpouring. And that's one of the reasons why I like the portables. Another question a person might be asked is, how do typewriters fit into my life personally? For myself, they serve as a means of communicating to a wider audience via blogging, using so-called typecasting, scanning or photographing typewritten pages and posting those images directly to my blog. They are, of course, a source of subject matter for this YouTube channel. I also, of course, collect them and fix them as part of a hobby, although, to be honest with you, the collecting aspect of typewriters is rather limited in my case because I don't have the room or the space for an enormous collection. So the collecting part of this is sort of secondary, but it is part of the reason why I enjoy typewriters, and certainly the maintenance of typewriters. Even with a small collection, a fixed number of typewriters, you're going to find yourself having to periodically go through and reservice them. So that happens periodically. But another important aspect of my personal typewriter usage is spontaneous creative writing. And I don't necessarily publish this or put it into books or whatever. Short stories, a little bit I've done. But a lot of it is just private writing of ideas that I squirrel away in notebooks. But these thoughts that are distilled down on paper become further inspiration for other writings in the future. And finally, I also am engaged in kind of a pen pal relationship with several people, and I use typewriters for that purpose also. Now, how is writing with a typewriter different from other forms of writing, either word processing directly or handwriting in a journal book? Well, first of all, I find with typewriting, it's primarily an unedited experience. It's simply harder to edit your thoughts on a typewriter because the process of correcting and even doing spelling corrections is a hassle. You have to interrupt yourself, turn the platen knob, move the paper up, slide it over, maybe use correction tape or some other form of correcting. So the whole process of correcting yourself as you go is a hassle, so you're less likely to do it. And the idea of editing your words on a typewritten page is really hard to do as you're typing. You can double space and then redline or edit the document afterwards and retype, which is how people did it in the pre-computer era. But I find the power of typewriters is that it's based on this idea of, and if anybody's taken a creative writing course, you probably know this phrase, but it's the idea of first thought, best thought. Okay? It's the idea of oftentimes the very first thought you have and the very first way that you express it on paper is the best way. It is the most spontaneous, and it expresses the deepest sense of what was in your mind at the time, or even in your subconscious, you might not even be aware of. So first thought, best thought, the typewriter brings that out especially good because there's less of a chance that you're going to immediately, halfway through the sentence, stop and correct and change and alter it like you would with a word processor. Now with a typewriter, you're more apt to continue typing that original thought, finishing the sentence or the paragraph. And so it becomes easier for you to document these very raw early ideas, which is really the power of where the typewriter comes into play in the creative process. I am reminded of the analogy to photography, where with digital cameras, it is easy to review a picture you've just taken, what is called chimping, on the back screen of the camera, and then make a immediate decision that the picture isn't good enough, I'm going to delete it and I'll reshoot it. What happens in that process is we end up deleting a lot of pictures that maybe would have been good if we had taken the time to let them marinate over a period of days, weeks, or months, and then revisit them and somehow process them in a different way to find something different and creative about them. Think about all the classic photographs from the 20th century that we wouldn't have at all if they had been deleted right after they were captured. So I think of that as an analogy to writing. First thought, best thought. Manual typewriters really work in the writing process by enabling us to capture raw, unedited snapshots of our early thought process about something. And that's why I think they're so valuable. Another question that might be raised is, what is unique about typewriters in this current age? Well, I think one of the most powerful things about typewriters is, first of all, as I said earlier, they're unmediated. It is an unmediated writing experience. It's a raw experience. I don't know if the analogy is apt, but it might be the difference between driving a car with an automatic transmission versus driving a car with a manual stick shift. It's probably a fairly poor analogy, but there are some parts of that analogy that hold true. You just have more control and more direct involvement in the process. I think the power of typewriters is that they are standalone and they are intrinsically disconnected and private. You have to go out of your way to share a typewritten text with someone. Either put it in an envelope, put a stamp on it and mail it, or scan it as a JPEG or PDF, or run that through some kind of OCR software and turn it into a text file. Somehow you have to jump through hoops to make a typewritten document shareable. In opposition to that, a word process document is almost intrinsically always shareable, and you have to go through hoops and go out of your way to make it private. And so that is one of the other aspects of typing, is it's not really about whether you're a terrorist or a troublemaker and you want to keep your thoughts secret from the government. It's not that. It's that oftentimes in the writing process, the creative process, we have early versions of our work that we just don't want to have shared. We want the privacy of our work process to give us a sense of calm and peace about that process, where we can be involved in it without any worry or bother. And so the intrinsic privacy of typing, I think, works hand in hand with the creative process. So it's not really about as much about security and being a spy and doing secret things behind people's back and that's why you type. No, I think it's just about the creative process is fundamentally a private process, right? Writers always go to their sheds, right? Their little secret place where they write, because writing in private is how we open up the channels of creativity and pour our heart out onto paper, right? So, you know, you can think of the privacy that comes from typing is a lot like much more effectively unconnected from the internet than anything else out there. It is physical only. It is on a whole nother realm. So Another aspect, though, of typewriters that I enjoy, and I guess my enjoyment of this is not maybe quite as intense as other collectors, but there is the history aspect of typewriters. There are other bloggers and video makers out there that are much better at this than I am, but there are whole fields of study of the history of typewriters and typewriter companies. But I find interesting is how many of the various typewriter companies came to a common understanding of what was the most efficient way to design a typewriter mechanism. So they all ended up, like in the 50s and 60s, ended up being very similar. Whereas if you look at the way typewriter technology started out in the very early days of the late 19th century, they started out very much different from one another, very unique and odd designs. I think you see some of this in automobile technology too. Like the early Fords, the throttle was a lever up on the steering column is how you controlled the speed of the car, whereas it became common to be a foot pedal. So there were common conventions that were developed in typewriters as they became more popular. And I find that interesting. I find the technology of typewriters interesting. I find their mechanicalness to be very interesting. All that is very enjoyable to me. I think typewriters are an extension of what you might call the Gutenberg technology. They are finger-operated printing presses, in a sense. And it's not movable type in the sense of type die that you put on a chase and put in a printing press, like in the case of Gutenberg, but it is an extension of the Gutenberg idea. The other thing about typewriters that you get into the sociological and historical usage of typewriters that I find interesting, and it's especially relevant in this current political climate, is that in certain countries and cultures in the 20th century during the Cold War, the typewriter was the primary means of communicating dissent and words and ideas and thoughts that would be counter to repressive governments and regimes, not just by journalists, but by other activists and artists. So the typewriter has this historical legacy of fostering freedom of thought, freedom of speech, and it has a legacy of opposing repressive regimes politically. And I think that's a very interesting history of the typewriter that I'm not so sure has been well documented. But those are my thoughts about why typewriters for me. Your reasons might be different. I'd love to hear them down in the comment section. And until next time, this is Joe Van Cleve, and have yourselves a great day.